Hi, today I'm here in the Church of the Pietà. This is a church just down the fondamenta from Piazza San Marco. And I'm here because it was the church of Anna Maria dal Violin. Now that may seem like a strange last name, her name is of the violin. That's because she was an orphan. And the Church of the Pietà back in her day would bring in orphans and foundlings. In fact, there was a sort of circular door where children could be put in, the door turned, and then the children taken in by the nuns who ran the school here. And that's exactly what happened with Anna Maria. Her last name comes from the instruments that she played. In fact, she actually had many last names because she was proficient at a number of instruments, but she was best at violin. The way it would work was the children would be brought in, they'd be sort of checked out that their health was good and so on, and then they would be sent to the mainland to be raised by a wet nurse until they reached a certain age. Then they were brought back here to the church, to the scuola really, and given kind of a small education in music and singing to see if they had any proficiency. Well, Anna Maria definitely did. In fact, she was so good at the violin that she became the special student of Antonio Vivaldi, who was a priest here. He was sometimes called the Red Priest because of his fiery red hair. He didn't especially love the priesthood, but he loved the music. So he taught the students here, which was primarily girls, and taught them music. He saw a special talent in Anna Maria, and so he trained her, and he wrote a number of pieces exclusively for her to play on the violin. And in fact, at one point, even gave her a violin so she could practice. So it's really quite incredible that these pieces were written for her, and even more incredible that many of these pieces have never been published. But there is a group out of London that has been recreating some of the music of the Pietà here in the church. And those pieces that were written for Anna Maria are in what's called a part book. It was her part book. It's bound in red leather, and it's kept now in another museum later in another part of the city. But during Vivaldi's time, this church didn't exist. It was actually built while Anna Maria was alive, and the Hotel Monaco next door is really the original building that she was raised in, and there used to be a small chapel there. It's now the Hotel Monaco, which is kind of cool. But this church was built during her lifetime, so later in her life, when she had finished performing but became a teacher, she still came to this church, and her students played music here. She lived in the church her entire life, or I should say in the school in the Pietà, and in fact she never left. She's buried here under the stones of this church. So this is quite a place. You know, it's known as the church for Vivaldi. He never actually performed or played in this church. Like I said, it wasn't built yet. So I think of it as the Church of Anna Maria. And to me, this is a special place just for her.